सनत बिल्डर्स एंड डेवलपर्स, घर सपना पलीकड़ से, फ्लैट प्राइसेस स्टार्टिंग एट जस्ट 14.5 लाख, नियर डोडामार्ग कोर्ट, 800 मीटर्स फ्रॉम गोवा महाराष्ट्र बॉर्डर.
टू अ क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड whether South Western Railway officials or any Goa government department has demarcated or marked on ground the land to be acquired for the project of doubling of South Western Railway track, the answer given is no. The site inspection was conducted, but the demarcation report has not been prepared. Speaker, sir, may I ask the Honourable Minister for Revenue the date on which this inspection was conducted and the authority that conducted the said inspection.
Speaker, sir, the site inspection was conducted between 15th of September 2019 to 10th October 2019.
Speaker, sir, I am told that the report has not been prepared. So may I ask the Honourable Minister for Revenue, what was the purpose of conducting this site inspection?
Speaker, sir, the demarcation which was supposed to be done was the report was not prepared because our department was only assisting the SWR to conduct the surveys. But the
Speaker, sir, but as per the answer, the demarcation was not done, but
no, there was
obviously if the demarcation is not done, what was the goal or the aim of this site inspection? Because at the end of the site inspection, no report has also been prepared.
Speaker, sir, like I said, the inspection was conducted, okay, and the demarcation notices were invited. See, let me just go from the beginning. Initially, there was notices that were issued to the affected people, okay. And if there was any dispute in the survey numbers or the demarcation, only then. The state was only providing use based support to the SWR. So that is the reason the demarcation was report was not prepared, but the site inspection was conducted.
But what was done during the site inspection if the demarcation was not done and the following report was also not written? I wonder what purpose was really achieved through this site inspection. Nevertheless, Speaker, sir, may I go to my next question? To a question asked whether land acquisition under Railway Act 1989 has received the Goa Cabinet's approval, the answer given is that since the acquisition is notified by the central government, the question of approval of Goa State Cabinet does not arise. Speaker, sir, may I ask the Honourable Minister for Revenue whether the Goa state government has no say in developmental works within the state, especially when the national project is detrimental to the welfare of the people of the state?
Speaker, sir, the government has not issued any directions to the concerned authorities to use the Railway Act for land acquisition. However, when it's a central government project, there is no need for cabinet approval once it's a central government project.
Speaker, sir, land for the project is being acquired under the Railway Act 1989. I have a copy of the letter dated 16th February 2018 written by Sri A.K. Gupta, General Manager of South Western Railway, to Sri Dharmendra Sharma, the then Chief Secretary, Government of Goa, wherein, under point 2 of his letter, he states, let me quote the verbatim from the letter: acquisition of land under the Railway Act would require joint measurements, JMC, to be conducted involving railway representative, state revenue authorities as well as the land owners. Speaker sir, this proves that what has been done is not per the Railway Act. So I would like to ask the Honorable Minister, when the Act says that if land is to be acquired under the Railway Act, there are certain joint measures to be followed, which involves the railway representative, the state revenue authorities, and the landowners. Yes. But none of these have been followed.
Yes, madam, that has been done. And for people to raise their objections, hearings are already on.
See, you have to also indicate to the people the land that is going to be acquired.
Yes, madam. So they were informed about it. It was published in the daily newspaper.
No. Okay. All right. Yeah. If that's your answer, I'll come to my next question. Speaker, sir, whenever development is planned, land is the greatest requirement. This land on which the infrastructure is planned could be government land or it could be private land. With reference to doubling of the Southwestern Railway track from Kulen to Vasco in South Goa, major part of the land for the project is private land. In this context, will the Honorable Minister for Revenue inform this August House whether a study giving details like proximity of the second track to the adjacent houses along the alignment and the impact due to raising of the ground level to lay the second track along certain stretches of the alignment, has it been done? Is the Honorable Minister for Revenue even aware that along the alignment there are many stretches where the land has to be raised? The land has been previously raised to lay the first track, and now the land is going to be raised to lay the second track. What is the government doing about this? Are the owners and the residents of the houses aware that this land is going to be further raised and it's going to be excuse me, please allow me to ask the question. I'm not talking to you. Now, has the government given any inkling to the residents of these houses how and how much will the land be raised? I mean, are the residents of these houses, the citizens of Goa, are they the citizens of this country?
Madam, one second, I'll answer your first question, where you said the majority of the land is private. So I have the breakdown over here. The total land proposed is 152.259 hectares, okay, where most of it...
Okay, that's fine. Yeah. I'm talking about private land, because in my constituency, Kortaling constituency, most of the land that is going to be taken over is private land.
Speaker, sir, in this diversion of forest land is 138.3916 hectares, which makes up 91% of the land which is needed for doubling. Transfer of government land is 1.7138 hectares, which is 1%. And acquisition and procurement of private land is 12.1536 hectares, which is 8%.
Speaker, sir, the main essence of my question is not about the quantum of land that is going to be acquired. The essence of my question is whether the residents of these houses along the alignment have been informed about what is going to be their plight should the second track become a reality.
Question is over. Zero hour mention.
No, sir. This is not fair. Let the Honorable Minister answer my question.
Over. Question is over. Over.
No. No, question please extend over. The time, sir. Oh, please extend the time.
Question is over.
Half an hour discussion
on the issue. Sir, my question has not been answered. Usually, you allow questions to go on beyond
never,
the time.
Never.
No, you do allow, sir. Never. I know. I've been after, present in this house.
After 12, it is not possible. Zero hour mention.
Half an hour discussion on this. We'll ask half an hour.
Sir, allow me. Sir, I happen to be the representative of the people of Kortaling constituency, and I owe them this answer. So I request the Honorable Minister for Revenue to please answer the question.
Question hour is over.
Half an hour discussion.
Because, sir, obviously there are no answers to my questions.
Why are you asking?
Half an hour discussion is required on this.
Let the member ask to the government.
I mean, we have raised the questions.
Vijay Sarjesai,
half an hour discussion.
Yes, sir. Ours is a democratic government, Speaker, sir. People have to know what is awaiting for them. And this is one way the people will know what is awaiting for them. It's easy for us to
sit down. Half an hour discussion is required, Speaker, sir.
No allowed.
It is very important issue.
Not allowed. Zero hour mention. You put the questions. You can speak on the demands. Why you are asking zero hour? After discussion on this issue. Why you are asking?
Speaker sir. The state government is acting as a puppet of the central government and sacrificing local interests.
Please go to the seat. Please go to the seat. There are 13 working days. There are 13 working days. House is adjourned for 15 minutes.
बेळगाव सारखी शॉपिंग आता गोयात शक्य फक्त बॉम्बे बाजारात. बॉम्बे बाजार घेऊन आयला तर एक वार प्रकारच्यो साड्यो, लग्न समारंभ आणि वेगवेगळ्या सोहळ्या खातीर खास साड्यो. त्याचबरोबर गिफ्ट करपाक 300 रुपयांच्या साड्यो, सिल्क साडी 900 रुपयांच्या सुरुवात आणि लेहंगा 3000च्या रेंजी पासून सुरुवात. शिलाई आणि एम्ब्रॉयडरीची खास सोय. तर आयजूच भेट द्यात बॉम्बे बाजार, 18 जून रोड, पणजी. प्राचीन आणि कलात्मक वस्तूंचो खजिनो जे तुमच्या घरात घरपण हाडटले. देवी देवतांच्यो मूर्ती असो किंवा पूजेचे सामान, शोपीस असो किंवा तरेकवार प्रकारच्यो शोभेच्यो वस्तू गिफ्ट करात किंवा स्वतःचे घर सजयात. आमचे डिझायनर शॉल आणि हँडीक्राफ्ट पळोवपाक मुजरत यात. आमचो पत्तो बॉम्बे बाजार, डिपार्टमेंटल स्टोर, 18 जून रोड, पणजी.
हँडीक्राफ्ट शॉपिंग only at Bombay.